Hello everyone, I'm here to talk about the Paranormal Activity 3 ending. It came out last week, last Friday. I saw it last Saturday, really liked the movie. I'm gonna say the whole ending, I actually really liked the ending, so I'm gonna give a lot of spoilers obviously because I'm telling the ending. If you do not want to get spoiled at all, leave now. I'll wait for 5 seconds. Okay, spoiler time! Oh yeah! In the house of Katie and Christy and the mom and the boyfriend, the mom is just doing kitchen stuff. Camera is panning around with the fan, which I thought was a genius idea. There was a lot of like utensils in the kitchen and like there was like all this kitchen stuff. And then the camera moved to the left. And then when the mom walked back, everything was missing and she was like, what? And eventually, BOOM! Everything that was like from the kitchen all fell down and the mom freaked out. Since she now realized that there was actually paranormal activity in the house, she decided to move to stay overnight to her mom's house, which is the grandma's house. So pretty much they were staying in grandma's house. And they go to sleep and this is when it gets really interesting. The mom and the boyfriend, or like husband or something, or fiance, they wake up and they hear this car outside. And then the dad was like what was that? And then the mom was like, oh, she has trouble sleeping at night. The mom went out, left the room to check it out. And then eventually later, she never came back. The fiance is now going downstairs to check it out. Something that was really freaky during this scene, but I'll show you an example. So pretend this is what happened. He took the camera, and then like he moved it to the right near the door. There was like this woman figure right here, and then he moved it again like this, so it doesn't show anything. And then he did it again. She was gone. His name is Dennis. He locks the camera. He goes in the room. He walks around to see if there's anything, and he calls Julie and the girls, which is Katie and Christy. He goes downstairs, and this is the part that terrifies me. He walks, and then behind the curtain, like he sees something. He sees a shadow, which is like this figure. It's like this woman. Dennis said, "Julie," and then he tried to see who it was, which, oh my god, so freaky. And then he went, and there was no one. When he was walking in the room, he saw that it was like a living room or like a family room for dinner, dining. And then there was two paintings that were on the walls, but it was taken down. When you see the wall, there was this mysterious symbol. And that symbol was this group of women in the 1930s who made these young girls possessed and all that. And then he sees that the backyard door is opened. He checks it out, he walks. It's like this big patio. He walks slowly. And then there's this door. He opens the door, it's like a long walk. And he opens the door, and BOOM! There was like these six or seven old women. He closes the door, and he freaks out. He like walks really fast. He closes the door, locks it, and then he sees the woman walking towards him. The old woman, like all six, seven of them, are the woman from the 1930s, the one who created the symbol. He goes back. And he checks if Julie's inside. He goes upstairs and he sees Julie and he says like, "Julie? Julie?" And Julie is like possessed and like she's just doing nothing. She's like on the stairs, like on the air, and she's doing this. And then like, so she's pretty much like doing this. Dennis like walks to her, and then Julie's body gets thrown at him. So it's pretty much like, after he falls, he gets up and he finds Christy, which is pretty much the daughter, which is pretty much the younger daughter, the woman in the second Paranormal Activity. They hide and they go in this closet. He's like, be quiet, like she's like crying. And then and outside there's these like doors like moving. Eventually they decided to go outside. When Dennis, the husband, and the youngest daughter Christy get out, he walks and he sees Katie, the main woman in the first one, who's the older sister. She is on the stairs, like sitting down, like crouching, and the mom's body is like dead. She's like on the ground, And then Dennis, the husband, like walks slowly towards Chris, towards Katie. Right when he touches her shoulder, she goes like, "Rah!" The dad freaks out. He like goes like this. He falls once again. 10 seconds or something. There's like no one. Like Dennis doesn't do anything, but he walks, and then he crawls to Katie. At the side, there is this old woman. One of the old women, just walking. And then she stops and turns towards him. And that old woman is the grandmother. Dennis looks up and sees her. All she does is stare. The husband, was slouching. And then he was like on the ground. His body was flat. And his whole body went like this and it cracked and then he died. Katie walks towards the grandmother. And the grandmother and Katie walk upstairs. Katie, from what I remember, tells Christy, "Come on, let's go." Christy walks up, walks towards the grandmother and sister, and then she says, "Come on, Toby." They walk up, and then the grandmother says, "Let's get ready." And then they walk up, and then in the ending, you hear this like monster breathing. It was like, and then after that, static on the camera. And then black, the movie ends. So comment below if you've seen the movie. What did you think the ending was? Like what do you think happened? Like the ending, like the last, when they walked upstairs, what do you think they did? So yeah, comment below. See you guys later.